Now don't turn around because she's coming in. Everyone, please stand for the bride. Who present this woman to be married?
I do.
Thank you, sir. Can you? Yeah. Can you help her with that? Help you with that, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Can you shake the gentleman's hand for us? Yeah. Thank you very much, sir. Okay. Simona, will you take your arm? That's good there. Okay. Everyone else may be seated for us, please. Dearly beloved, we're gathered together here this precious, wonderful, exciting, lovely, beautiful evening here in Las Vegas, Nevada, in the little Church of the West, to bring together Mark and Simona in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate. It's instituted by Almighty God. It's declared by St. Paul to be honorable among all men. It should not be entered into without holy advice or lightly, but reverently, sober, advisedly, and in the fear of God. I'd like to charge you both on your precious, spectacular, wonderful, loving, miracle evening here as you stand in the presence of Almighty God to remember that true love and faithful observance of your wedding vows are required as the foundation of a successful marriage and the establishment of a happy and enduring home. Without these, there can be no real marriage, and the home that you will endeavor to establish will be a vain effort. Keep the solemn vows you are about to make on this wonderful grand evening. Live with tender consideration with each other. Conduct your lives in honesty and in truth, and your marriage will last. Mark, Simona, in the Holy Bible of the Old Testament, in the book of Proverbs, God spoke through King Solomon many years ago in the 18th chapter, the 22nd verse, and it reads as follows. He who finds a wife finds a great treasure and obtain favor from God. And we all need favor from God. And in the New Testament, in the first book of Corinthians, in the 13th chapter, it's referred to as the love chapter. As the Spirit of God moves up on the Apostle Paul, he begins to write, and this is what he writes from the Spirit of God. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not love, I become as a sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. If I have the gift to understand all mysteries and all prophecies and have faith that I could remove all the mountains in the world and yet not love, it profiteth me nothing. If I give all my money and clothes to the poor and my body to be burned and still show no love, the writer said that he became nothing. But he did not stop there. As the Spirit of God continually to move up on him, he begins to define what love is. He goes on and he closes out his letter as this: love is kind. Love is patient. Love does not behave itself unseemly. Love seek not her own way. Love is not arrogant. Love is not jealous. Love is not puffed up. Love keep no records of wrongdoing. But love believe all things. It hope all things. It endure all things. Now we have these three: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these will always be the love you two special, wonderful, precious people will share on this journey here. Your love will conquer and overcome all the wind, the rain, the storms, or any adversity that may try to enter into your life or your marriage. If it be 100 years from today, whatever you may encounter, always remember it will be your love that will see you through. Simona, may this lady hold your flowers for you, please. And I need Mark and Simona to turn face one another, hold hands, look one another straight in the eye, and let's repeat some wedding vows. Going to take you first, Mark. I, Mark.
Take thee, Simona.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Richer or for poor. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
I pledge my faith.
I pledge my faith.
Thank you, Mark. I, Simona.
I, Simona.
Take thee, Mark.
Take thee, Mark.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
Richer or for poor.
Richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us apart.
I pledge my faith.
I pledge my faith.
Thank you both so kindly. Mark, will you take Simona's ring? Put it on her left hand, third finger for us, please. Simona, will you take Mark's ring? Put it on the left hand, the other left. Third finger. Thank you both so kindly. Continually to hold hands. Let us all have a prayer for the success and the prosperity of this wonderful couple's marriage. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this loving couple. Father, we ask you that you would bless this couple, lead them and guide them in the right direction. Give them wisdom, give them knowledge, give them clarity. Let this marriage be a success, let it be prosperous, let it be an example to the whole wide world. We invite you to be the honored guest here this evening in their lives. Turn the water into the wine of joy. Let them know that they have been brought together by thy holy providence. And may they always experience respect, compassion, friendship, love, joy, peace, laughter, happiness throughout eternity. In Jesus' name, amen. With the authority that is invested in me by Almighty God in the state of Nevada and being a man of the gospel, I gladly, joyfully, happily pronounce you husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the sweet Holy Spirit. Those who God has joined together, never let no man put asunder. You now may kiss your wonderful wife. Let's give him a big hand, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations, Mark.